And we're really worried about the future.
I'd like to see a place that is the home of the free.
I'm for women's rights, period.
Massive sense of outrage at the election of Donald Trump.
Donald Trump, go away! Shame on you!
That we don't believe in a misogynistic narcissist as our president.
The obvious question on everybody's lips was, is this a moment or will it turn into a movement? What's next?
How will those who rally turn the Women's March into action?
What happened after the election is that there was such a shock. Women felt more at risk, more that gains they thought had been won and settled were suddenly in play, and that motivated people in a way that the election didn't motivate people to turn out. I think no one expected the enormous turnout around the country and around the world. It was so much larger than anyone had thought. So this was this kind of first moment where I think you got a glimpse of the depth and breadth of the resistance. And it was led by women. The march gave an impetus to a protest movement, and the big question was it going to be a kind of one-day wonder?
The Women's March leaders want supporters to join the launch of a new campaign, 10 actions for the first 100 days.
A range of organizations started putting this surge to work.
Organizers say every 10 days they plan to take action on an issue they care about.
When you look back at 2017, there are several key women-led surges of activism. One of the most tangible and most immediate fallouts had to do with health care. So you saw women sending postcards to their members of Congress, flooding Capitol Hill with phone calls, and storming constituent meetings.
Is rape considered a pre-existing condition under your law?
It was that opposition, in addition to fractures within the Republican Party, that stymied multiple attempts to eradicate Obamacare. No, then you have the emergence of the Me Too movement. And that has been another women-led, almost spontaneous eruption of anger and collective sharing of experience. And then I also think we've had unprecedented numbers of women who have expressed an interest in running for office at the state level, at the local level, and for Congress and a gubernatorial post.
But I know at the end of the day, we will win.
There are a number of challenges. There are women who might oppose Trump, but who felt very excluded from these marches because of their unabashed embrace of progressive causes.
By not allowing us to participate, the entire media narrative this week was Women's March doesn't let pro-life women march.
So that certainly alienates some groups, but overall, in a midterm election like this, it does seem to provide a kind of army of politically motivated people. And so I think the energy it provides, at least liberal groups see that as a blessing.